refrain from applause until all graduates have been recognized, and that you refrain from shouting or in any other way disrupting this solemn ceremony. At a student assembly on Thursday of this week, the Honors Assembly of the High School in this gymnasium, the entire ceremony was conducted without even one such outburst. May we as adults show the same degree of respect for the efforts and accomplishments of these young people. The class has asked that you remain seated during the processional so that everyone might see. In some past years, when everyone stood, some were unable to see, and last year we found it worked better if anyone could ever remain seated. We ask you to honor that today. I also wish to inform you that the senior class, by its sole determination, voted to include an invocation and benediction in these exercises. The school district and its officials, by law, cannot and does not either endorse or oppose this decision. Again, I'm pleased to welcome you. The most meaningful and lasting experiences in life are observed in dignity and quiet decorum. May your presence here and the students' achievements together be cause for such an experience this present day. It is now my distinct privilege to introduce to you the president of the class of 1993, Ms. Angie Garner.
All of you here today. It is a pleasure for you to be here to witness this very special event. Stacy Coy is the daughter of Reggie and Gail Coy in Bedford. She has been involved in art club and creative writing club. She is also a member of National Honor Society and was inducted into the Wawasee High School Academic Hall of Fame. She will attend Purdue University this fall and major in pharmacy. I feel honored to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 1993, Stacy Lee Coy.
Gentlemen of the school administration, fellow classmates, parents, and friends. Our past was just a second ago. Our future is just a moment away. Our high school experience is now a part of our past. How we utilize this experience will determine our future. All that has previously occurred in our lives, kindergarten through grade school, making friends, losing them, jobs we held, secrets we've never shared, dealing with parents or losing them to death or divorce, our pets, hobbies, and problems, beliefs. All the good and bad elements of our past lives will have a tremendous impact on how we will react and respond to the demands of our future. As we approach it, perhaps college-bound, vocationally oriented, single or married, with or without children, remaining in our school community, or relocating abroad, whatever our choices, we will borrow from all past endeavors to assist us in reaching our goals. Like strong tall trees, our roots are embedded deeply, drawing essential nutrients from our past, so our new green branches can reach skyward towards the future, bending and swaying with the breeze, never breaking against the winds of change. May we always keep our soil nourished through further input of continuing education, adding to this an increased level of personal, moral, and social integrity. So like the trees, we may also stand proud and tall above all the rest. In closing, let me share with you these words from John F. Kennedy. I look forward to a great America, a future in which our country will match its wealth with our wisdom, its power with our purpose. I look forward to an America which will not be afraid of race and beauty, which will protect the beauty of our natural environment, and an America which will reward achievement in the arts as we reward achievement in the things we should have. I look forward to an America which can win respect throughout the world, not only for its strength, but for its civilization as well. And I look forward to a world which will be safe not only for democracy and diversity, but also for personal distinction. Thank you.
Thank you.
4-H, volunteered at Teen Parents Succeeding, and was active in her church youth group. Through her academic excellence, Jennifer was inducted into the National Honor Society, the Academic Hall of Fame, and has the distinction of being number one in our class. Following a year of working as a nanny in Philadelphia, Jennifer will enter Purdue University in the fall of 94. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pride that I introduce to you the valedictorian of the graduating class of 1993, Jennifer Renee Beer.
Inspiring speaker, Jerry Powell.
love others more. I would let this love express itself in concern for my neighbors, my friends, and all with whom I came in contact. I would try to let love permeate me, overcome me, overwhelm me, and direct me. I would love the unlovely, the unwanted, the unknown, and the unloved. I would give more. I would learn early in life the joy of giving, the pleasure of sharing, and the happiness of helping. I would learn to give more than money. I would give some of life's treasured possessions, such as time, thoughts, and kind words. If I had my life to live over, I would be much more unconventional, because where society overlooks people, I would socialize with them. Where custom acknowledges peers as best with whom to have fellowship, I would want non-peer friends. Where tradition stratifies people because of economics, education, race, or religion, I would want fellowship with friends of all strata. And I would choose to go where the crowd doesn't go, where the road is not paved, where the weather is bitter, where the friends are few, where the need is great, and where God is most likely to be found. Just a few days ago, my mom told me, "Jenny, you are really lucky. You have your whole life before you. Mine is already half over," she said. But I should have told her, "Mom, you still have half to go. Whether you be young or old, you still have days left." So I say this to all of you, straight from that Jesus. Congratulations! Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. Thank you.
Superintendent, during the year 1968-1969, Mr. Don Carter.
Assistant Superintendent of Wawasee School Corporation, Mr. Henry Smith. These three men prepared well for the rest of us for these first 25 years. We appreciate it. The opportunity to graduate doesn't happen very often, yet it doesn't happen to everyone. The fact that these seniors have successfully completed high school is commendable. The ingredients of being successful exist in each senior here today. Each person has a varying amount of success instilled in them, depending upon how much they study, how much they can retain of their knowledge, and most of all, how willing they are to continue to learn and grow as individuals. The important concept for growth is to realize that there is more to learn. The foundation has been built over the years for seniors to experience success. A foundation to be solid needs strong cornerstones. I will speak briefly about the cornerstones of knowledge, common sense, honesty, and faith. Knowledge is a cornerstone upon which great, successful people have built meaningful lives. The collecting of knowledge and using this knowledge wisely is very important. Gaining of knowledge with no practical use of it is somewhat meaningless. Knowledge is a tool for use forever. No one can take away from you that which is stored in your brain as knowledge. It is the foundation for the understanding of how to accomplish tasks throughout life. Knowledge is used to solve complex math problems, such as the balancing of your checkbook, or the solution to Einstein's theory of relativity. What a person knows allows one to be a mechanic who solves problems for people like myself. For I'm definitely not a mechanic. Another cornerstone is common sense. We use common sense every day in many ways. For instance, we look before we cross the street. Those of us with common sense would not do things others do, because we can see the danger of it, or the futility of it, or we understand that there are consequences if we mess up. An example of a person who had knowledge but lacked common sense is the fellow who read about recently in the newspaper. It seems that he wanted to join one of those all-male clubs for space flights in the survival training. To show his manliness, he had to be initiated. That usually means doing something really dumb. And we men do that down there. I don't know if you noticed that or not. The initiation was that he had to hold a can above his head and someone else, probably not a very wise person either, was to shoot an arrow through the can. The can holder held the can. The archer shot the arrow. The arrow missed the can, but struck the can holder in the eye. The arrow went through the man's head. He survived this, and he told the reporters that he thought what he had done was pretty stupid. My point is this. A person with common sense would never let himself be talked into holding a can. Allow common sense to keep you from being the can holder of your life. Honesty is another cornerstone of life. Honest people tell the truth and suffer the consequences if they have done something wrong. This is the familiar George Washington cherry tree lesson. Some people say that rules force them to be dishonest. I suspect these people choose to be dishonest because a person is wanting to protect someone from the consequences of their actions, or because they found a rule that's inconvenient for something they wanted to do. I don't feel rules cause people to be dishonest. For instance, when I was stopped for speeding, it didn't occur to me to say to the officer that it was the speed limit that was at fault. If it had been for the limit, I would have been speeding. Why do I mention this? Because I believe the foundation for a good life for our children rests on how wisely we make decisions that seem small, but speak volumes to our children each day.
believe that that's policy, it allows us to live in a clear conscience and sets a good example. Faith is the final point of showing our faith. I believe it will serve each person well and here today if he can spend time searching for greater meaning in life. Faith brings greater meaning than even the most menial of tasks. Faith allows us to look beyond ourselves and the concept of, what's in it for me? And we grow into the concept of, what good will I be able to do for others? The here and now, feel good society has taken its toll on families, on America, and on the world. Consider the child abuse in our communities. The drug rage for middle-aged people are being arrested. And the continued emphasis on sex and violence in advertising, movies, and music. These are all symptoms of a society that has too little faith and too much of a mean emphasis. The cornerstones I've spoken about are knowledge, common sense, honesty, and faith. As each of you go forth into the rest of your lives, what choices are you going to make? Are you going to be the can holder? Put your faith in the archer? Or are you going to be the foundation builder who puts your faith in the life and the greater meaning for life that exists within each of us? The choice, after all, the choice. To assist in the presentation of diplomas today, the assistant principal of Wawasee High School, Mr. Jim Wazier, as he reads the name of each recipient, we ask that he listen with respect. So each graduate's name can be heard thoroughly. Our seniors are all deserving of their diploma and are deserving of equal respect from family and friends. Mr. Lockwood.
David Gillian.
Ken Reeves. Daniel A. Graves. Amy Marie Pratt. Brad Richard Dunn. Erica Joanne Lang. Jonah M. Beer. Teresa A. Winger. Matthew H. Wilkinson. Julie Renee Brown. Jamie Alvarado. Joshua David Galloway. Brandon L. Lozano. Anna Laura Myers. Christopher Peterson. Catherine Eileen Summerlot. Gabriel Lee Ritter. Leslie Jane Wright. Mun Tran. Stacy Evans. Chad M. Williamson. Angela J. Madeira. Ron Church. Elizabeth D. Sewell. Jeremy David Price. Monica Gray Wallace. Barry Lee Lamb. Ann Ratha. John David Andrew. Erica Lozano with distinction. Timothy A. White. Sheena Renee Flitter. Adam Eugene Steele. Tammy Turner. Christopher Raymer. Amber Irene Miller. Melanie E. Meadows. Michelle R. Smith. William A. Soul. Nicole Aileen Baker. Aaron Brent Reiner. Sheree Lynn Brokers. Dan R. Atkins. Tina Marie Coleman. Philip D. Fish. Rachel Michelle Ryder. Jason Robert Pippi. Alyssa Johnson. Jason Cameron Neff. Lisa Lane Lotz. Eric J. Losey. Samantha L. Johnson. Benjamin D. Hoy. Michelle Lynn Hall. Christopher L. Ganshorn. Kelly Renee Story. Shane L. Beter. Stacy Lynn Shivington. Ted Crummy. Deborah K. Black. Karen Story. Jason Lynn Orton. Amanda Catherine Smith. Eric Allen Shackle. Krista Renee Smith. Gregory Richard Brecker. Catherine E. Schwartz. Eric W. Myers. Christina Marie Ridgeway. Timothy Allen McFerrin. Rebecca Jewel Meyer. Corey Manning. Pamela Miller. Jason Edward Klein. Heather R. Mann. Brian Kaufman. Michelle Lee Lehman. Melissa Parker. Jared L. Peace. Amber C. Brown. Christopher A. Peterson. Randy Michelle Carlson. Ryan K. Schumaker. Amanda Del Fuente. Ryan Van Hook. Brandis Michelle Dahl. Eric Lamar Berger. Trisha Danielle Hostetter. Peter Brandon Nijinko. John Edmonds. Nanette George. Jeremy L. Fricky. Lorelei Lynn Fry. Stephen Michael Yargos. Ashley Marie Dick. Robert W. Street. Harry E. Brown. Scott R. Pelletier. Denise Bender. John L. Noble III. Chad Hardy. Christina Marie Kelly with distinction. Chad Diffin. Erin Michelle Moore with distinction. Daniel C. Brand. Jennifer Lynn Seemeyer. David Kearns. Amber Dawn White. Michael Andrew Liberty. Jennifer Lynn Weiler. Anthony Stephen Lund. Denise L. Zaniga. Kyle L. Newcomer. Jeannie Marie Allen. Matthew Ryan McClintock. Trisha Lynn Weidrich with distinction. Spencer Long. Harry Lynn Wingard. David Jake Leonard. Jill Suzanne Seemeyer. Sean B. Hacker. Amy E. Riding. Philip Anthony Gilhouse. Angela Jean Lehman. Chris Pro.
Sean M. Arnold. Billy J. Evans. Matthew R. Beer. Betsy Ann Henderson. Ryan Andrew Gore with distinction. Heather Diane Fancher. Jason L. Avery. Crystal Lynn Football. Rex A. Wirt Jr. Tammy A. Clark. Christopher J. Mullins. Gretchen Ann Hobler. Brad Beer. Leanne Tyler. Arian Lindsay Lilly Jr. Kelly Joe Dewey. Kelly M. Bowman. Gregory Brent White. Michael D. Furda. Randy K. Gray. F. James Hoover. Georgie Heiser. Thomas Wire. Micah Nielsen. Till Garrett. Carolina Handgrass. Wayne Hartman.
Members of class of 1993, set out to face last minute challenges. We ask that you generously bestow upon us your countless blessings. We ask that throughout life, we may have the character to avoid futility and temptation, and that we may always have the compassion to care for others as you have cared for us. We ask that our achievements and successes be guided by your infinite wisdom, and our disappointments and sorrows be comforted by your undying love. And finally, we ask that you forever watch over those teachers, administrators, role models, friends, and family members who have influenced and led us to become who we are today. We trust in you, Lord. God bless the class.